In Surah Ar-Rahman, and this is our ninth presentation. Tomorrow, of course, is again is the night of Qadr, so on Sunday will be the last 10th presentation. We'll try to cover as much as possible. Today, we'll try to go quickly at some of the verses without getting into detail, so at least that we can cover most of the verses. I would like to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this wonderful opportunity that we begin our session here with Quran presentation, a surah, and try to understand it. Now, this started when we moved here into this facility from Bayview. We saw the first day that there were so many elders who were not participating in Quran Khani. So we decided that to run a Quran tafsir or Quran explanation program, you know, simultaneously with the darsa. And that has been continued since then. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the effort. So let us look at ayat number 33 onwards now. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا معشر الجن والإنس إن استطعتم أن تنفذوا من أقطار السماوات والأرض فانفذوا لا تنفذون إلا بسلطان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يرسل عليكما شواذ من نار ونحاس فلا تنتصران فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is amongst his all beneficent and bounties which has been, you know, just reminding us in this beautiful surah. Now comes to the say that, O company of jinn and humans, if you can pass through the confines of the heavens and the earth, then do pass through. Here you can see the word which Allah uses is, you know, sultan, right? You will not do that except through the authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This shows that the authority of, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is supreme. That human being, if you can pass through the confines of the heavens and the earth, then do pass. But you will only not, you will not pass through except by the authority of Allah. Of course, some of the commentators says that this ayat is also one of the ayat which invites for us to explore. Human beings decided to go out of this earth because Allah has given that authority. Allah will give you that ability and the intelligence that you can come out of this earth. And you can see now the exploration is there, that they claim that they're going to the Mars, they're going to, you know, the moon, all those things. You can see, but this kind of thought, again, keep in mind, we have been discussing this thing again and again, the scientific aspects that certain things like this 14 centuries ago. Today, of course, because the science has advanced so much, so we can comprehend such these concepts. But at that particular time, to even think, people did not even go out of Makkah, would not go out of Arabia, right? At that time, for example, to tell somebody that you go out of the universe and go to another planet, right? This is what Allah says. فَبِأَيِّ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ تُكَذِّبَانِ. 31 times Allah is just asking us this question. Remember, I told you this is invitation. The questions in the Quran, which comes again and again, is an invitation for us that we should, in fact, you know, always ponder over the creation and all these verses, right? Which are the bound, which are the, you know, bounties of your Lord? The two of you will deny. That means the jinn and ins. Now, then Allah says, "Now yursalu alaykuma shuwazun min narin wa nuhasun fala tantasiran." So which, you know, there will be unleashed upon you a flash of fire and a smoke, then you will not be able to help one another, right? For ayyi adar bakaziban. Verse number 35 here is talking about inability of jinn and the human to evade divine justice. Now, this is one of the about interpretation that, as they said, that when Allah is going to send the flash of fire and smoke, you will not be able to help each other. You cannot escape. So when Allah's, you know, time would come for us to give the justice, right? We cannot escape the divine justice. No. On again, verse number 3, jinn precedes men in this verse. This is interesting, right? Because you can see, ya mashal jinni wal insi in istatatum an tanfuzu min aktari samawat. So the commentator says jinn precedes men in this verse because jinn exceed men in terms of quantity, and also were created before men. So there are more jinns than the human beings in number and also their creation. In another verse, Quran says that Allah created them before that. No? We had discussed this earlier. O jinn and men, if you truly intend to evade divine recompense and chastisement, make an attempt to transcend and the boundaries of the heavens and the earth and thereby leave the bounds of His omnipresence. However, you may never be embarked upon the same unless through divine might, and such might is not at your disposal. So it is only Allah will allow us, otherwise you cannot escape the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? And this is it. You may never ever evade the tribunal of justice. Whenever you go, you shall be in divine realm. Wherever we go, we'll always be under divine realm, right? And whenever you stand, it shall be His sovereignty. Mawla Amin Munin Salawatullahi wa Salamu Alayhi. We say this in Dua Kamil, right? وَلَا يَمْكُلُ فِرَارُ مِنْ حُكُومَتِكَ. There is no way that we can do firar, that means escape and run away from your hukumat. I remember there was a time, one day, they came to Bahlul and said that, Bahlul, they said, you are so smart and intelligent. You know, can we find us some kind of loopholes, excuse that we can commit sins? No, and will not be punished or no, it's okay for us. Bahlul, of course, very smart. He gave 5 to 6 ways you can do it. But one of them was, he said, okay, I'll give you 5 to 6 ideas. If you can do these things, then commit sins as many as possible. So when he said like that, the whole market was full of people, right? Because they wanted to hear what are the ideas, because they knew, although he was pretending to be a mad, but he was intelligent, right? And I remember when I was my first exposure to Islamic literature was in Gujarati, before, of course, English and Arabic. So when I was young, I remember reading an article, Bahlul Dana Ke Diwana. Was Bahlul an intelligent person or a mad person? So Bahlul said, one way you can just commit sins as much as possible is that you go out of Allah's kingdom, Allah's sovereignty. They said, is that not possible? No, what are we talking? So he said, if that's not possible, how can you commit sin? How can you disobey Allah when you are within His sovereignty? Right? Do you see this? So here it is. That have been told, oh, jinn and men, you can never escape, right? Don't even try to embark upon a situation whereby we can just try to be evade tribunal of divine justice. That is not possible, you know. So keeping that in mind, and that is the central theme of the Quran, if you see. One of the central themes of the Quran is that we are human beings, we are creatures, Allah is the Khaliq, and we are answerable to the Khaliq. A makhluk is answerable to the Khaliq. This is a central theme of the Quran, you'll find. So again here you can see, this is being told, وَلَا يَمْكُمْ فِرَارُ مِنْ حُكُومَتِكَ, right? They will never be able to evade God's commands and decrees, except with Allah's authority. For though they may have intercessors, none will be able to intercede save by His leave. Yes, sometimes, for example, we will be able to, you know, just try to pass some of the things because somebody will do shafa for us. But mind it, even the shafa also comes because Allah has given izn, right? That permission, if for example, your parents will become your shafi, hadith says Quran become your shafi, hadith says the shahada can become shafi, a'imma will become shafi, rasul become shafi, right? They all be intercede on our behalf. All these people who are going to intercede on our behalf, your alim can be your shafi, right? You can different hadith. But this is, if Allah gives them that authority, otherwise there is no shifa. Okay. So we are answerable to this, and this verse is being reminding us now. The next verse Allah says, "Idan shakkati samau fakanat wardatan kadhihan, fabi ayi alai rabbikuma tukadhiban, fa yoma izin la yusalu an dhanbin insun wala jan, fabi ayi alai rabbikuma tukadhiban." When the sky is split open and turns, you know, crimson like tan leather, no, because Hurdan Katihan, this is just like a tan leather, right? Now Allah is talking about once the world comes to an end, and you'll find this order will be completely upside down. At that time, how can you know? When the sky is split open and turns crimson like, no, you'll see this. At this moment, how can you even deny that Allah's blessings? Subhanallah, Allah says here, Allah Rabbakum Tukaziban. Although this is, we may say that when the day of judgment comes, it will be like terror, right? We'll all be confused. But even then, Allah calls it as Allah, as the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because in reality, Keep in mind, when the day of judgment comes, when the world comes to end, you'll find that everything, all the order, no, there is no order and there'll be so much confusion. How can that be a bounty, right? The real is that for a believer, it's a bounty. If for a disbeliever, it's not a bounty. A believer is waiting for that moment to meet his Lord and just be given, you know, the reward for all the kind of belief, as we are going to see, you know, and the deeds, right? One day they asked Abu Zar, they said, "Ya Abu Zar, why is it that we, you know, abhor death? Why is it that we dislike death? Why is it that there is karat against death?" And he said, "It's very simple, that because you have built this world and you, you know, ruined your akhirat. So nobody wants to, you know, actually move from the built place to a ruined place." But then he says, "You know, what about those who are believers?" He said, "As far as their believers are there, for them there is Jannat, Na'im, right? So keep in mind that if we have built this akhirat, then we are waiting for that moment. So even if the world comes to an end, and for example, as we are told, that the sky will be split open and there will be disorder in the whole system, there will be so much confusion, right? For believer, that would not be a problem because he is waiting for that moment to pass through this thing and for that reward, right? For yawma izin la yusalu an dhanbihi insun wala jan. Subhanallah. On that day, you can imagine human being and even the jinn will not be asked about his sin. This is quite interesting. Even when I just looked at it from the face of it, I said, I must look at the tafsir of this thing. But let's look at the translation, right? It says, on that day, neither humans will be questioned about their sins nor jinn. فَبِأَيِّ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ تَكَذِّبَانَ. Again, which of the bounties of Lord would you deny? No. Here it is, the further descriptions of the sins of resurrection and the manner of attending to records and divine recompense, right, is coming. We have been told that how these divine recompense will take place, right? Stars, planets, the earth shall undergo alterations completely, as we said, there will be confusion. Many incidents shall occur which may not be imagined by us. You know, you cannot even imagine the way they'll be upside down in the whole system, the whole universal system you can find, they'll be upside down, right? They shall not be questioned concerning their sins, Allah says here, right? Since everything shall be evident on the day of emergence, Yawmul Buruz. That is why one of the name of the day of judgment is Yawmul Buruz. Now, Baraza is to just come. For example, when Ali Akbar was sent to Maidan, at that time, no, Imam Hussein, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, has a beautiful dua. He says, Allahumma lakad barza ilayhim. No? Oh Allah, such a young lad has now gone to the battlefront, that who used to look like your prophet. Whenever he wanted to do ziyarat of a prophet, we look at him, right? So the word Imam used is baraza. So you can see even the day of judgment is Yawmul Buruz. That means everything that shall be exposed. My bad deeds, nauzubillah, the guna which I committed, nauzubillah, right? I don't need to say what I have done. It will automatically be exposed. No? So you can see that there is no point of asking because things will be exposed. And the faces reflect everything. Even the face, you know, subhanallah, as we are doing wuzu, what do we say? Oh Allah, brighten my face on the day when the face will be darkened, right? And let not my face be darkened and the face will be brightened. So how would the face be brightened? On account of belief, right? Subhanallah, that every time, now we are discussing of wuzu, there was a hadith, I couldn't get chance to exactly get the hadith, but the gist of that I remember, that somebody came to the Prophet and said, Ya Rasulullah, what is there for us in wuzu, right? He said, yes, of course, besides you are just helping to clean your soul, but don't forget, when you wash your face and your hands, you know, at the same time, the sins of your get washed the way you find the leaves falling from the tree. Right? You can imagine. So this is I'm mentioning because I know sometimes the elders, the seniors, they complain. They say that, no, we have to go and renew our wuzu again and again. is there not a shortcut to that? And I said, I realize, I know it's not easy, because even I'm getting senior, I know that now we face these challenges, no? That, for example, we have to go and renew wudu because of gas, we have to go and renew wudu, for example, because we get sleepy, right? Thing of sort, or for example, Ramadan, even youths complain that they can't get enough sleep, right? So we find that Malana is giving lecture, I'm giving lecture, people are dozing, so they have to go and renew the wudu before namaz. This is common, right? We understand this thing. But keep in mind that this hadith of the Prophet is a kind of, you know, at least, you know, that kind of consolation, that every time you do wudu, right, there is like, you find all the sins being washed away. In fact, the sixth Imam, Imam Jafar Sadiq, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, has a beautiful hadith. He said, wudu after wudu is nurun ala nur. You know, subhanallah, if you have wudu and you go and renew your wudu, right? It is nurun ala nur. It's a flight over light. Do you see this thing? So this is, we are not even trying to just renew the wudu. We are just trying to, you know, do a wudu because the wudu broke about it. That's not a renewal of wudu, right? Renewal of wudu, that means I have wudu. Let's say, for example, I did my wudu before I left home because I know I got a lecture. When I left my home, maybe it was 7 p.m., right? By the time namaz will be said, it will be 9 p.m. So it's, you know, two hours, right? I think it's too long. So I go and renew my wudu. Even that, and my wudu is not broken. I'm just renewing it, right? And Imam says it is nurun ala nur. We are complaining of not renewing. We are complaining that my wudu broke. Why should I go and, you know, renew it again? Is there a shortcut that one wudu can do for everything? No, we can't do that, right? So keep in mind that, so here is it, that the faces will automatically show that this person is a mujrim, a sinner, or this person is righteous. Do you see this thing? So they will not be asked. There is no question of asking, right? Let us look at also other verses. وَلَا يُسَلُوا عَنْ ذُنُوبِهِمْ الْمُجْرِمُونَ You can see, Quran is telling you very clearly. Ayat number 78, Surah Al-Qasas, and the guilty will not be questioned about their sins. Now, all the signs will be there on their faces, on their bodies, on account of all the sins. Mumineen, you know, if we were to see the sin of a sinner, if Allah were to expose for us somebody who is a sinner, what will be he would look like, you know, we will not even near him. There is a beautiful hadith in the in Hadith al-Qudsi. Allah says, if I were to reveal about you and about your actions, about deeds to your friends, they would not even greet you. They would not even sit next to you. You know, subhanallah, it is the mercy of Allah that I am sinner, but even you give salams to me. I'm sinner, but even you stand for me, not knowing, right? This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that should not mean we should forget. We should be careful that, you know, for example, imagine if Allah were to reveal and expose my sins. You would no longer even say salam to me. Do you see this thing? So, وَلَا يُسَلُوا عَنِ ذُنُوبِهِمْ الْمُجْرِمُونَ هَذَا يَوْمٌ Another verse, right? هَذَا يَوْمٌ لَا يَنْتِكُونَ وَلَا يُزَنُ لَهُمْ فَيَعْتَذِرُونَ Subhanallah. That is the day on which they should not speak. There is no question of speaking. Because when you start speaking, then all kind of excuse there. Oh, I committed this sin because of this thing. No, there is no. The mouth will be just sealed, right? There is no talking and arguing there, right? هَذَا يَوْمٌ لَا يُنْتِكُونَ This is the day on which they shall not speak, nor is permission granted them, such that they might offer excuses. Do you see this thing? Because there is no permission. Because once you open the mouth, then all the kind of excuses. One day, you know, in the Toronto Star, many years ago, there was an interesting article. The police officer who just gave tickets, right, to those who overspeed or this thing, he collected all the excuses people give, you know, and they were printed, no? If you read them, you really feel like laughing. You can see people at that particular time, because they were caught speeding or, you know, just running the red light, they come up with so many excuses and ideas, right? Subhanallah, those days are gone. On the day of judgment, Quran says, هَذَا يَوْمٌ لَا يَنْتِكُونَ This day, there is no talking. وَلَا يُزَنْ لَهُمْ فَيَعْتَذِرُونَ They will not even be given permission that they start giving excuses. Do you see this thing? So this is really mind-boggling, because we should be very careful before committing sins. The whole idea is that we are answerable. Remember I told you, it's a central theme of the Quran, right? Again, an ayat which we recite, Surah Yasin, we remember, right? Allah says, الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِمْ وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ No. Mumineen, we recite Surah Yasin so often. These are the things which should just make our hairs rise, no? Raise our hairs in our hands and know this thought, no? Imagine that day, why would anybody even commit sins? You know, especially the month of Ramadan is the best time not to ask forgiveness, but then promise Allah not to repeat. You know, if I'm not forgiven this month of Ramadan, Prophet says, then which other month you can be forgiven? You know, so inshallah, all of us will be forgiven by the time of Eid. But then that would really mean something and beneficial if we promise Allah not to return, right? So Allah says, Al-yawma nakhtimu ala afwahim. On this day, we are going to seal their mouth, right? Wa tukallimuna aydihim. And we are going to not only their mouth will be filled and their hands will speak to us. Wa tukallimuna aydihim. Wa tashhadu arjuluhum bima kanu yaksibun. And their feet will bear witness to that which they used to earn. That means, if I used to go to haram places, my feet is going to bear it, no? That these are the feet which has gone to these haram places, these things, right? Because sometimes people, when they go on holidays, oh, yeah, the koi khojo nahi hoy, yeah, the koi musliman nahi hoy. Chalo, we can go to, no, casinos and good all this. No, we are staying away from Allah. Allah is seeing in the law, basim libad, Allah is watchful over his servants, right? So the question, yeah, koi hoy ke nahi hoy, will there be here or not, doesn't arise for a believer, right? A believer always think, will Allah see me or not? And that's why, Bahlul says, go out. He said six things. Right? Ramadan says, go out of the sovereignty of Allah. Go to a place whereby Allah cannot, nobody can see even Allah. Then commit sins. They say to Bahlul, that's not possible. So since there is no place that Allah cannot see us, why would we even, disobey Allah? Sometimes, I remember nowadays, of course, the youths have, with due respect, the respect for the parents have gone, but I remember during my time, I never smoke, alhamdulillah, I never smoke in my life, but my colleagues who used to smoke, they'll always say, they'll tell me, go and check my dad is there or not, is my grandfather is there or not, no, otherwise I smoke, right? So out of respect of the dead, although smoking is not haram at that time, although nowadays there are fatwas of haram, but those days it was not even haram, but out of respect, they would not smoke in presence of their father or grandfather. And we commit sin in presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where is the logic, right? You can see. So subhanallah, and again in another ayat, Allah says, and their ears and their eyes and the skins will bear witnesses against them for that which they used to do. And that is why Allah says, on that day they will not be asked any question, right? Because the sins itself will be just shown, right? We go to the next ayat, right? I only have 4 minutes. يُعْرَفُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ بِسِيمَاهُمْ. You can see it continues the same thing, right? The same theme. يُعْرَفُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ بِسِيمَاهُمْ فَيُؤْخَذُ بِالنَّوَاسِ وَالْأَقْدَامِ فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. The guilty will be recognized by their marks. سِيمَاهُمْ is marks, no? So they will be seized by their forelocks and feet. Which of the bounties of Allah would you deny, right? The guilty will not be asked about their sins because they will be known by their marks. Compare this. Now, the believers will be known by the light that shines from the parts of their bodies which they wash when performing wuzu. Remember, I was telling you, compare this which mujrimun with a believer. A believer will be known immediately because he used to do his wuzu correctly. Now, mind it, my face will shine off because of doing wuzu if my wuzu is correct, right? If I do my wuzu, which is not wrong, then it doesn't matter. One day, Mawla Amin Mumin Salatullahi Wasalam Al Islam was passing by a young lad. Hassan Al Basri, he was very young. An imam stopped there and said, Hassin wuduk, try to just beautify your wudu. Imam must have seen that the way he was doing wuzu, maybe not okay. So imam stopped there and advised him that beautify your wudu, right? So you can see, compared to the guilty, the believers will have the light on their face on account of the wudu they have performed. Not only that, no, you can see in another surah, this is surah number 48, beautiful, right? Surah Fath, Allah says, Simahum fi wujuhim min atharis sujood, subhanallah. This is Allah says, Prophet and his companions, right? When they used to do what salat, tahajjud, they say, that سِيمَاهُمْ فِي وُجُوهِمْ مِنْ أَثَرِ السُّجُودِ, the mark upon their faces from the effect of prostration, right? The angels will drag them by the forelock, but this is the guilty, or the, by feet, right? When they say that, فَيُؤْخَذُوا بِالنَّوَاسِ وَالْأَقْدَامِ, that means the angels will drag them by the forelock or by the feet. In other words, Allah says, مَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ مِنْ آخِذٍ بِنَاسِتَةٍ. Allah says, there is not a creature that crawls, but he holds it by its forelock, right? Allah has a total control over his creatures, that he holds by the forelock. And you can see on that day, مَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ, Dabba is everything which crawls on this earth, whether it's human being, animals, even insects which crawl on this earth is Dabba, right? So this ayat says, وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ آخِذٌ بِنَاسِتَةٍ, there is not a creature that crawls that except that Allah holds it by forsake. So these are some of the verses which by clearly reminding us about our responsibility towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there cannot be a better month than Ramadan, in which we are fasting from dawn to dusk, and that fasting and thirst and hunger is the best reminder that we should not commit sins. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah give us tawfiq to recite the Holy Quran in the month of Ramadan. May Allah give us tawfiq that we are able to understand the Holy Quran. May Allah give us tawfiq that we are able to reflect on the Quranic verses. And most important, may Allah give us tawfiq that we are able to, you know, follow the commands and stay away from those things which are forbidden, as taught and practiced by the Prophet in his Ahlul Bayt. Wa salli ala Muhammad wa ala al-Tahirin. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Rahim Allahu man qara al-Fatiha. Bismillahir Rahman.